So this week, we're starting a new series looking at some of the miracles of Jesus. Now, a miracle is something that only God could do. It's something that no person would ever be able to do by themselves, and that's what makes it miraculous. So let's jump in and see what today's miracle is all about. A few days later, Jesus entered Capernaum again. The people heard that he had come home. So many people gathered that there was no room left. There was not even room outside the door. And Jesus preached the word to them. Four of those who came were carrying a man who could not walk, but they couldn't get close to Jesus because of the crowd. So they made a hole by digging through the roof above Jesus. Then they lowered the man through it on a mat. Jesus saw their faith. So he said to the man, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Some teachers of the law were sitting there. They were thinking, "Why is this fellow talking like that? He's saying a very evil thing. Only God can forgive sins." Right away, Jesus knew what they were thinking. So he said to them, "Why are you thinking these things? Is it easier to say to this man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up, take your mat and walk'? But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." So Jesus spoke to the man who could not walk. "I tell you," he said, "get up, take your mat and go home." The man got up and took his mat. Then he walked away while everyone watched. All the people were amazed. They praised God and said, "We have never seen anything like this." So this man was paralyzed. And that means he couldn't walk. It means his legs didn't work. And this was way, way before wheelchairs were invented. So the only way that this guy was going to be able to get around is if his friends carried him on his mat or carried him themselves. So he probably didn't go a lot of places very often. And I'm sure after so long, this guy probably felt like he had no hope of ever walking again. But then he and his friends heard about Jesus. And if anyone was going to be able to help him, it was going to be Jesus. So they packed up. They went to go see this man. And when they got there, there was too many people. They couldn't get to the house. But Jesus was their last chance. They totally trusted that Jesus was going to be able to do it. So they got their friend to Jesus the only way they knew how, through the ceiling. And this is the part where things get kind of weird. You see, Jesus didn't start off by saying, "I'm going to heal you." No, what did Jesus say? He said, "Son, your sins are forgiven." They had come to see Jesus to get this man's legs working again, and it didn't seem like sin had anything to do with that. Let's stop and think for a minute. Yeah, Jesus could fix this man's legs. But eventually, this guy was going to get old. Things were going to start breaking down again. And eventually, he was going to die. Jesus fixing this man's legs, even if they worked for a long, long time, was still going to be a temporary fix. But Jesus could do something to help this man forever. See, Jesus wanted to heal more than this man's body. Jesus wanted to heal his soul. Sin is what broke our relationship with God in the first place. Sin is the sickness that got into our soul and started to break down everything. Jesus came to fix that problem. The problem that we have a harder time seeing, but is way, way bigger and lasts way longer. You see, Jesus ultimately came to stand in our place. He took the punishment that we deserve for sin. And not only that, but he rose again from the dead, showing us that we would too, just like him. So that when we did rise again, we would have a new life with him, a full life, a better life. So yeah, to the first people who heard it, it might have seemed a little funny that Jesus told this man that his sins were forgiven. But we can see now that Jesus came not only to heal us in the short term, but to heal us for good. Today we learned that Jesus has the power to heal a man who couldn't walk. But Jesus came to fix a bigger problem than that. Jesus came to heal our souls. Jesus came to fix the problem that sin had made, to put God's good creation back together and give us new life with him. Let's talk to him now. Dear Jesus, thank you for healing us, inside and out. Thank you for coming and doing what we couldn't, so that we could have new and full life with you. Jesus, we ask every day you forgive our sins and help us to leap out of bed to walk with you better and better. We pray this and the prayer that you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us for our online family worship. If you'd like to hear more about this story, please check out Pastor's Message here on our channel. Have a great week.